By now, you should have created a basic diagram in your project. For me, this is mainlevel.tgml. Before we add more pages, let's look at how our menu system works. Inside Studio, I can navigate to my project folder by clicking Open in Explorer. And then navigate down into my TGML folder. Here I see my one diagram as well as one-line configuration.json, which we will look at in a later video. The directory structure of the TGML folder defines the items in the diagrams menu. If I duplicate main level and rename it to something else, like domestic terminal 1, and then refresh my diagrams, I see the new link pop up. However, as we'll see later, there may be pages that you don't want to show up in the menu, like pop-up pages or per-device help pages. If I add an exclamation point to the start of the file name, it will no longer show up in the menu. We have other methods to access these pages from within the diagrams, which we will explore later. Finally, any folders I create within TGML will be displayed in diagrams as subfolders. This way, I can logically organize my diagrams into folders like floor plans, one lines, summary pages, and so forth. I'll move my new page into a floor plans folder now. That said, folders that do not have any diagrams to display will not show up in diagrams, whether the folders are empty or only contain system pages. That way, when we start building large numbers of pop-up pages, we can put them in their own folders without those folders showing up in the menu. This is the simplest way to build out your diagram's menu structure in the WebHMI. Now I can add the remaining floor plan diagrams to my project. Later, we'll look at some snippets to navigate directly between those diagram pages. Until then, thank you.